What is UPnP, and why do we recommend disabling it? All about it in this video. But before we start, you should hit that subscribe button if you want to get similar videos about cybersecurity. And don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications. So, what's UPnP? Sounds like the name of a K-pop band, doesn't it? Actually, UPnP stands for Universal Plug and Play, and it's a protocol that allows apps and devices to connect automatically to your network. That way, your devices do act like a K-pop band, working together, working in concert, if you will. Unfortunately, it's not all song and dance. UPnP opens a door to multiple security vulnerabilities, and here's how. Home devices connected to your router create the so-called local area network, or LAN. Everything outside this network, website servers or your friend's computer, is on the wider area network, or WAN. Now, no one outside your LAN can access your devices unless you let them. For example, if you want to use your new printer, you need to connect it to your computer. But UPnP automates the process. So devices can automatically join a network, obtain an IP address, and find and connect to other devices on your network. Now, that's really convenient, but not very secure. Many router manufacturers now enable UPnP by default, making these routers discoverable from WAN. If hackers discover your router on WAN, they could pretend to be, for example, your Xbox, and send a UPnP request to your router. And then the router is going to let the quote-unquote Xbox onto your network, no questions asked. Now, that's one gaming console that's not going to bring you joy. So once the hacker gets on your network, they can wreak all kinds of havoc. They can get remote access to other devices connected to your home network, or they can install malware on your devices, steal sensitive information, or use your router as a cover to attack other targets. To protect yourself against UPnP vulnerabilities, you should make sure that your devices are running updated firmware. And unless UPnP is necessary for your network, you should disable it. In that case, your router is going to ignore incoming requests, so you'll have to set up devices manually. It's going to be a bit more of a hassle, but your security is worth it. Have you ever been victim of a UPnP vulnerability? If so, leave a comment down below. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more videos about cybersecurity. In fact, here's some of our favorite videos on cybersecurity. Check them out and stay safe.